Hello, fellow Nikon users. Today we finally have a webcam utility, but it's in beta, and pretty much we're going to be the guinea pigs to test it out. And I'm going to walk you through how to download it. There's a little trick to this and get it to work on your computer. So when you get to the download page, I will provide a link down in the description below, but make sure you watch the video before you go down to the link, because otherwise you might end up coming back here. All right, right now I only see Windows. I don't know if it doesn't support Mac yet, but, or I don't know if it's automatically detected that I use Windows. So Windows, scroll down here and make sure you accept and you select your region. I don't know why that is important, but it makes you do that, and you now go ahead and hit download. Now, for some reason, on the Nikon rumors page, it said you should download it, create a special folder to download it in. So I just downloaded it into my downloads folder, and then I created a special folder on my desktop called Nikon Webcam, and then I copied it in here. So once you copy it in there, you double click it and you run it as usual. Say yes. And then you go through the clicks. Now, here's the big trick with this thing. When you install it, after you have installed it, you will not find a desktop shortcut. It's not there. There's no shortcut, there's nothing. So, yeah, that took me a while to figure out. And after you've installed it, it's just installed. The best part is that you don't even need, USB 3.0. Any USB port will work for this. All right, so that's awesome. So now let's test it out and see how to use it. So I am going to StreamYard. That's what I like to use to stream. And guess what? StreamYard is free. So in StreamYard, I can go here and create a broadcast. Okay. And then let's say I select my broadcast here. I'm going to call it the Nikon Webcam Utility Test. I'm actually going to leave this broadcast on for a little bit. Testing out the Nikon webcam. Oh, Webcam. Webcam utility app. Okay. And I'm going to leave this as public, and I'm going to just create broadcast. Now, those of you who have used StreamYard before, you know, it limits us to 720p. Oh, look, there, I'm already showing. It automatically selected the Nikon utility, but if you have used it before and use something else, it might be on a different camera, like OBS camera or something else. So just click the down arrow here and select the Nikon webcam utility. See, the EOS utility was here too. So I think I'm dark. I'm going to give some light to my face here so I don't make Nikon look bad. Crying. Oh, look there. All right. So this actually looks pretty good. It might be 1080p. I don't know. We'll see. All right. So now that I've selected my camera, I am just going to go enter broadcast studio. So I'm actually going to go live on YouTube right now while making this video, just so you see how it works. And I have to add myself to the stream. And man, I'm getting old. Oh Lord. Okay. So I am going to go live just for the sake of going live, and I kind of like the clarity on this, I'm not gonna lie. because I used to use the Elgato 4K cam link, and it was good, but this feels like it's straightforward. I don't, you know. All right, so I'm going to go live, and going live on YouTube right now. Live. Go live. So I'm actually recording this. I'm recording this right now with OBS, and so I am going to have to probably close these and go and export the video of how to do the install and all that, and then bring it back up in here. But I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave this live on so that if anybody else comes on and I can help, I will. So let's see. Live. So yeah, the quality is good. I only have a 50 on there and it's working just fine. So go ahead and test it out. My video, I have a video which I'm going to post like in an hour about the about how to install it and get it started. So yeah. All right. I think I'm just gonna end the live for now and see.